Welcome to gig number 12. Gig number 12, which places us firmly 98 days into the lockdown. I haven't updated my list on the wall there. What's that, 90 there or something? But yeah, day 98, imagine that. And for gig number 12, we are live from the 1960s, where we're going to be playing almost entirely songs from the 1960s, with one exception, which I'll explain in a little bit. But great to see everyone's kind of slowly arriving over here. And what? I can't even see some. His name's Ducky Mint. Don't know what that is. Do feel free to do a right-hand kind of click on your name there, Richard and Jen. If you do a little right-hand click on yourself and change your nickname to your name, and then I'll remember that Ducky Mint is you. But welcome. Nice to see you. So we've got, as usual, 10 songs for you this evening. And the first one, as we look, I'm cutting this short because I was watching last week and thinking, this guy just drones on inanely for about 10 minutes before we even start. Let's cut to the chase. We have here the first two songs. The first one is, as always, one of my own. Now, sure enough, you might be sitting there thinking, well, surely, Finn, you weren't born in the 60s, you know, with your fine complexion and your not entirely grey beard. You must have been born in the 90s, surely. Well, I was born in the 70s and obviously not in the 60s. And my justification for putting this song in here is that this is my gig, me and David's gig, and we do whatever we want. There you go, there's justification for you. You think that's acceptable, David? Yeah, he just nods his head over there, as a dutiful son should. So that first song is called Little Girl. And it is on my album, it's available. from 1,000 years ago, but post-60s. And the second song is from the great, possibly the greatest ever band, called the Beatles. You might be familiar with them. And it's called Norwegian Wood. Now, there are loads of... We were going to do Help at this point, just so... Because we were going to start off with something quite early on in their time together as a band. I had about 8 people ask for Norwegian Wood, which is weird because it's a weird song and doesn't make any sense unless you're going to tell me that it means something else. But just reading the words, it sounds like he went to someone's house and then they went to sleep and then she had gone when he woke up. So we had a fire. I don't really understand. Anyway, maybe it's got some hidden clever meaning, but probably not. So that's Norwegian Wood second. So we're going to start off with my song, Little Girl, and then Norwegian Wood. For all of them peeps, what ask for it?
Little girl, we tried for too long now. The days are moving fast to join 1,000 others in the past. Little girl, it's been going wrong now. The journey's left me tired, and in the end I think we might have tried too hard. Your life seemed to go away from mine. So I'm sailing away, sailing far, far away, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sailing out to sea, beyond the city of our dreams today. learned to give much more. I'd learned to live much more. I'd learned to love much more. That's why I'm sailing away. Sailing far, far away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Sailing out to sea, beyond the city of our dreams today.
If you make any sense of that song, you're a better person than what I is, because it's weird. Sleeping in the bath? I don't know. So anyway, that was a song by me and a song by the Beatles, so pretty good company there. I hope everyone's very well and looking forward to... Is it this coming Saturday that we're... Is it the 4th this Saturday? I can't recall, but I seem to think it is, and that we're getting slightly let out of our cages somewhat, which would be good. I've been away all week prepping for it over at the Isle of Wight, and I've just got back. So David and I are just kind of making this up somewhat as we go along. We have it to go through and just get things running and all that. Let's see who's here then. So we've got Lucinda's here. Watcha. That's so eight, isn't it? Watcha, mate. Who else is here? Peter and Craig, good to see you. The Coolicks. Joel, Richard and Jen.
Hi there.
Darren, Mum and Dad. Hello, Mum and Dad. Barbara's here. Karen's here. Marcus is here. Blimey, actually, look at this. There's Sue's here. Just looking through these names. Dramatic individual, always welcome. And what's that say? Weevil... McSmall. I don't know what that means. What does that mean? Who is that? It'd be nice to know who that is. But you're all exceptionally welcome to our 1960s gig. And to continue this, we have something that, in fact, David's run away from the next song because this song is it's really about the drums. This song, ignore what I do because it'll be all rubbish. But it's got this kind of samba rhythm going. I'm talking about Sympathy for the Devil. It starts off with about, I don't know, 14 percussionists and 3 drum kits, which David will be handling entirely on his own with just his arms and legs and drums and sticks. So that's Sympathy for the Devil, and that one is for Russell, who hopefully is out there with Sue. Sue, let me know if he's there, but hello, Russell. We haven't met, but one day we might. Then we got Waterloo Sunset, the Kinks, and gosh, I haven't written down who this is for. David, did you? All right. Sounds like a Jules. No, there's nothing on my notes either. Apologies. I seem to recall Peter asking for this one, but I think someone else did as well. Well, I mean, if you ask for this, it's for you and enjoy it. Dave Day's there. Watch it, Dave. Good to see you, buddy. That's Waterloo Sunset. Did I say that? By the Kinks. And I'm in a bit of pain because I keep bees on this roof right here. And so we end up with a few bees kind of who haven't made it back to the hive sort of land in front of the studio. And they often land on the path. So I tell the kids, make sure to put shoes on when you're outside. Otherwise, you're going to tread on a bee and get stung. And just before we came in, I tread on a bee and got stung. And it is... starting to swell and is uncomfortable. So if I just collapse during this, that's why. Or I can blame it on that, can't I, David? What have I said here? So super tough drum part, good work. I've made a note here that doesn't make any sense. Oh, I saw the Rolling Stones. That's what I was going to mention. I saw the Rolling Stones live. I think it was 2003 with Jules. Good and glad Jules taking me out to see. I think that's one of the few big live gigs I've ever been to. That was the Stones up in Sheffield. And it was slightly ruined by the fact we had 2 pints of Guinness each before we went in. And then we got right up the front. And of course, you're then about 10 miles away from the toilets. And so I spent the whole gig wishing it would end so that I could go to the toilet. So there you go, that was that one wasted. Good, let me just set up the keyboard. Hopefully that's not too much strings on your thing. Oh, hello, Izzy, family and friends. Nice of you to join us. Who are the friends? Greetings, friends. Right, let's have a look. Oh, David, yeah, David's starting this on. So this is Sympathy for the Devil by the Stones for Russell. And then we've got Waterloo Sunset, the Kinks for the people who asked it for it. Did I mention I met Ray Davies? Did I mention that last week? To introduce myself, I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year, stole many a man's soul to fame. And I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made sure I'm sure that Pilate washed his hands, sealed his fate. Pleased to meet you, hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. I stuck around in St. Petersburg when I saw it was the time for a change. And his ministers, Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a general's rank when the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you, hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Watch with glee while your kings and queens fall.
shouted out, who killed the Kennedys? When after all it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I lay traps for the troubadours who got killed before they reached Bombay. You have to bring the ooze later, by the way. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Just as every cop's a criminal, and another sinner's saints. His heads, his tails, just call me Lucifer, cause I'm in need of some restraint. So if you meet me, have some courtesy, have some sympathy, and some taste. Lose a little bit of politics, or I'll lay your soul to waste. You keep rolling, rolling into the night. People so busy, makes me feel dizzy. I see light shine so bright, but I don't need no friends. As long as I gaze on Waterloo sunsets, I am in paradise.
Waterloo sunset, I'm there in paradise.
Time for this bit. Ready, David? Whee! that was underwhelming. This one. Hey, what was that? What was that underwhelming celebration? Good grief, they stink. What was that underwhelming celebration for, you might ask? Well, that was our 100th song in on our lockdown gigs. Number one, that's ridiculous, isn't it? Number 100. Congratulations to David and to me and to all of you for joining in and being part of this ludicrously long and drawn out thing that's happening. Cheers. Right. Okay, next one, as per usual at this point, we're going to have a couple of guitar-y ones. Now, as I say, I've been away this week and I've not had any actual guitar access, so this could be fun, couldn't it? The two we've chosen, though, the first one is for Darren, who I know is out there because he was with my mother and father watching this. This one's for Darren. It's called The House of the Rising Sun. You might be familiar with this. It's by The Animals. And it is literally the highest thing I've had to sing yet. In fact, you'll basically be hearing me screaming for... How long has that song last? About 2 hours, roughly. For roughly 2 hours, you hear me screaming The House of the Rising Sun. So apologies in advance for that. But, you know, why not, eh? For 101 song. And then we've got a bit of Van Morrison, a bit of Brown Eyed Girl. And there's a little intro to this, and I'm going to see if we can kind of fumble our way through that intro. And then when I come to edit this video and put it up on the YouTube, I'll just put it in properly. So that's good. Shh, don't tell anyone. And I can't recall who that one's for. Who requested Brown? I've not done very well at keeping a tally on who's asked for what, am I, this week? Apologies about that. But that's Van Morrison, Brown Eyed Girl, for whoever asked for that. So super high. First, let me just get my guitar. Okay. Once again, just talk amongst yourselves. Just for a moment, just tune this up. Okay, good. As I say, this is super high, so apologies. How's the rising sun for Darren?
God, I know I'm one. Mm-hmm. of the rising sun.
Kind of survived that. My word, but that House of the Rising Sun was loud. In fact, it was so high, I had to almost dislocate my jaw to sing that. And then almost went back up there again at one point in The Brown Eyed Girl. But don't worry about that. Don't worry about it. So that was House of the Rising Sun for Darren and Van Morrison, Brown Eyed Girl for somebody. I don't know. We are making our way through these. So who else is there? Oh, Jules is there. What's your awesome? Yeah, I love the intro to Brown. I go, yeah. And my wife has just arrived over there, the other side of the camera. You're going to be our camera lady. No, she's just going to sit down over there. That's fine. Okay, let me see where we are at. Still don't know who Dramatic Individual or Weevil McSmall is. Don't know who you are, people, but you're still very welcome. So our next couple of songs we're just taking it down a little bit. We have got a high one coming up. Surprise, surprise. I think maybe I just have a very small vocal range. I don't pretend to be a singer. I'm a piano player, a guitar-y, and sort of hide in the corner. I don't usually sing. So these last 102 songs, it's been an interesting experience. And it's lovely for you all to be part of it. Lovely for me, for you all to be part of it. And for David, who's run off again. Where's he gone this time? He's gone off to, what are you downing there? Cider, is it? Dear, oh dear, this kid. Okay, so the first of our songs here is Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. I'm not going to try and do the voice of Louis Armstrong because that would be disrespectful and it really hurts my throat. But I played this, I played the piano bit, someone else sang, yes, for my grandma and granddad's golden wedding anniversary, which was, I don't know when that was, like the year 2000 or something, or might have been, yeah, a long time ago, when Mari was pregnant with David, I think, yes, so this is before you were born. I played this song. Apparently, I have no recollection of it whatsoever. I don't know who sung, I guess my little sister sang, maybe Adele played the flute and Russell maybe. But do you know what? I've got absolutely no idea. So if anyone has any better recollections, do let me know. But we're going to do A Wonderful World. So this is for Grandma and Granddad, who's sadly no longer with us. But we can still do a song for them all the same, can't we, David? And then we're going to follow that up with Frankie Valli, Can't Take My Eyes Off of You. That's the high one. And I've tried this in so many different keys. Today, I should be trying it in the key of F. So we shall see how that goes. I did try it in the key of B flat. That was no good. The original was in G, which is definitely too high. But this one is for Pat and Colin, who are down at the British Legion, although they're not quite yet down at the British Legion, but very soon it will be opening its doors. I believe this Saturday, Colin's going to be opening the doors and they'll both be up there. And in fact, next Sunday, after next Sunday evening's gig, which I should tell you more about later, we will be popping down to the British Legion. We get there about 8:45 or so. Anyone who wants to come down and join us post-gig next week, you're very welcome. And that would just be a nice little... And I presume they've got all the social distancing stuff going on down there, so you have to keep... You have to do all that. But to be honest, after doing a gig, you want to keep at least one... About 2 metres, maybe 3 metres away from me. So, yeah, that would be fine. And about 5 metres from David. Next room. So, next Sunday, down the Legion. See you all there. So that one's for Pat and Colin. Can't take my eyes off of you. Must remember to not play it in G. Okay, David, you ready? I'm not. Just
sort this out. Strings. Keys.
Hopefully that strings isn't overpowering. Sounds like that, doesn't it? Okay, we'll see. If it becomes overpowering, we might just stop. Okay, here we go.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue. For me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright and blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. Watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I will ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a
I love you.
That there was a bit of Louis Armstrong, Wonderful World, and a bit of Can't Take My Eyes Off You by Frankie Valli for Pat and Colin down the Legion. So then, what are people saying there? Can't take my eyes off of you drumming. Drumming is fabulous. David, he said, you can't take your drum. Oh, okay, there should be a comment there. But I don't know. Skokian, Marcus. Yeah, do you know what? I did actually have a little go at Skokian. That's another Louis Armstrong number. Absolutely ludicrous. But again, I mean, it's cracker. You should definitely go and hunt it down and check it out. Boo 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 boo. Russell says thanks. What do we play for Russell? We did that other song to me. I just forget the songs. So I just pick them up and throw them on the floor, and that's as if I've never played them in my life before. That's how I usually do business, anyways. But you're very welcome, Russell. Of course. Oh, it was the diamond dew, wasn't it? Yes, not the golden one. All right, thank you, Weevil. Weevil McSmell. That's got to be Leafy then. Hello, Olivia. All right. Okay. The next two songs are also the last two songs of our 1960s set, which I hope you have enjoyed. The first of these is by, once again, the Beatles. So good, we got two of their songs. This one is for my mum, since last week it was Father's Day, wasn't it, David? Yep. Yes, he said. What are you doing over there? You're texting people. Oh, yes, okay. Right, fair enough. It's the Beatles, All You Need Is Love. That's for Mum. And then we're going to follow that with for Maureen, who's there with the other Kooliks. We'll be playing I'm a Believer by the Monkees. And I'm expecting everyone to go, oi, at the right appropriate moments. Anywhere in the song, really, feels appropriate. What else does this say? Nothing in particular. Rock piano down here. Just sorting out the pianos. Is that rock? Okay, what else do I need? It's not going to work, is it? So I'm just trying to work out. I'm going to put a piano up there, I think. This is what's called being mildly disorganised. Is that piano up there working? Okay, got a piano up the top. Down the bottom, we're going to put bit of strings. Yeah, bit of strings and a bit of an organ. So the organ. This is the funnest bit, isn't it? Me fiddling around with this keyboard while David taps away over there like a. Tapping item. Okay, that one's strings. We got that. Am I gonna send this one? We'll go with that, David, and see how it goes before everyone has left due to my boring bits. Okay, All You Need Is Love for Mum, and All You Need Is Love for Your Mum, and I'm a Believer for Maureen. Oh, I need something else, don't I? Where's the piano gone? Oh. I'm going to have to... Oh, no, I can't do that, can I? No, I can't have that. Oh, my word. I've completely messed this up. I'm just gonna have strings down the bottom and then leave it. Yeah. We'll have to have a break between the songs, which is so unprofessional.
Love, love, love. Love. Love, 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 love. Nothing you can do that can't be done. Nothing you can sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say but you learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can do to make can be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do but you can learn how to be you in time.
It's easy. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. Is all you need. There's nothing you can do that isn't known. Nothing you can see that isn't shown. Nowhere you can be that isn't where you're meant to be. It's easy. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love is all you need. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you
only true in fairy tales.
I
meant for someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me. Da-da-da-da, that's the way it seemed. Ba-da-ba-ba, disappointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. Thought love was more or less a given thing.
Oi.
Seems the more I gave, the less I got. What's the use in trying to da 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 da? All you get is pain. Ba ba da ba ba. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer, not a trace. Love was out to get me, ba-da-ba-ba, that's the way it seemed, ba-da-ba-da, disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face, now I'm a believer, not a trace, no doubt in my mind, I'm in love, oh yeah, I'm a believer, I can leave her if I try. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer, not a trace. No doubt in my mind, I'm in love. Oh, I'm a believer, I can leave her if I try.
Thus that song endeth. And so endeth our gig of the 60s, of the 1960s, that is, in case you were confused. That was All You Need Is Love by the Beatles for my mum. And the Monkees, I'm a Believer for Maureen. So cheers, I hope you enjoyed that. My word. That's a thirsty work, isn't it? So that's brought us up to 106 songs thus far. And so David and I have decided to do something a little bit different next week. We're still going to be doing a gig. Don't worry about that. We won't be deserting you. It's calm, calm. It's all right. However, we're not going to be doing the 1950s. We're going to be doing something a little bit different. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but I might just, if you go to, say, our Facebook page, the Hall Music Studio, or just send me an email or a text if you got all that details. I just want to know what your favourite Christmas song is, just for no reason whatsoever. So if you send them in, that'd be good. For now, I hope you've had a fantastic evening. Enjoy the rest of your week. Look forward to being let out next week. And remember, after next week's gig, we're going down the British Legion. Whee! To sink a few beers or to play a game of put. I don't know what we're allowed to do down there, to be honest. I guess a drink would be fine. Maybe a packet of crisps with, you know, antiseptic wipes or something for each crisp. It'd be great to see you down there. About 8:45 we should get down there. What time is it now? Yeah, look at that. It's almost 8:30 now. So yeah, that should give us enough time. All that leaves me to do now is to say goodbye. Have a fantastic week. Love and kisses from Finn and David. And see you all same time next week. Bye.